You're here because you want to send your audio from OBS to Zoom, Teams, or your preferred video conferencing platform. If you're doing the setup for the first time, don't worry, I'll guide you step by step. If instead you've already tried to set up your audio in OBS, but like me, you've experienced sync issues, then you are at the right place, because I show you the right way to avoid this issue. If you're new to OBS, I highly recommend you watch my beginner's tutorial up here. In order to set up things correctly, we need to do two things. The first one is to install a plugin. The second one is to install a virtual audio cable. Let's go to OBS and get started. First thing we need to do is look for the Audio Monitor plugin OBS. You should get to the first result here. Let's click on it, and this is where you will be landing. Currently, the latest version is 0.7.1, but you may have a later version depending on when you're watching this video. Let's click on download. In my case, I'm downloading the Windows version, and then you will unzip the file and install the software. At this point, you may have to reboot OBS. Now let's open OBS. I have the default scene 1, which is empty, and in the audio mixer, I have the desktop audio and my microphone, which is the Blue Yeti. Let's go to the cogwheel here, click on it, and select filters. To add a filter, we click on plus, and here, after installing the plugin, you'll see Audio Monitor. Let's click on it. We can keep the name Audio Monitor. If you've already tried to send your audio from OBS to your video calls, but have experienced a sync issue, so a delay, especially a delay in the video, the reason might have been the following. So let me take a step back. I'll close this. The way I tried to do it before this plugin was available a couple of months ago was to monitor my audio through the advanced properties of the audio source. What I used to do was to go to advanced audio properties by clicking on the cogwheel here. And under my mic source, I was selecting monitor and output, in order to capture the monitored audio and send it to the video call. But regardless of the value that I was introducing in here in milliseconds, for example 300, I was not able to see any effect of the sync offset in my video call. Also, I was not able to hear any effect I was applying to the audio. No compression, no noise gate. The reason for that is that the audio that's been monitored by OBS is the audio that comes straight from the microphone before any processing. Let's go back to the point where we left. Filters. And we see that the audio monitor filter is still there because we applied it before. The next step is to select the device. If we select our headphones here, for example, in my case it's called Cask, then the audio will be monitored, so will be heard through your headphones. You will hear yourself while you're talking. This will be handy for some of our future applications, but for now, that's not what we want to do. We don't want to hear the audio in the headphones, instead we want to send it to the video call, back to default here. In order to send audio from one application to another, we need a so-called virtual audio cable. What's a virtual audio cable, you may ask yourself? Well, let's start from a hardware audio cable. You all know the hardware audio cables that have an in and an out and that are used to connect two pieces of hardware. Since now we want to connect two pieces of software instead of two pieces of hardware, we need an extra piece of software that simulates an audio cable. That's a virtual audio cable. Let's go back to Google and search for VB Audio. That's where you will find a free audio cable ready to download. So let's Google VB Audio. First result is good. And here we are at the VB Audio software homepage. Let's go to Audio Apps. And here we find the VB Cable virtual audio device. You click on download for Windows or for Mac. And here's your VB Cable driver pack. Just run the executable and install it as any other application. After you've done that, you may have to reboot OBS. After rebooting, let's go back to our audio monitor filter. Again, let's click on the cogwheel, filters, and here we are at audio monitor. In the device list, you will see cable input VB Audio virtual cable. I have a number of other virtual cables installed, but you don't have to worry about them. So click on it, and here we are. Now we have virtually connected the jack of our virtual cable into OBS, which is now ready to send the audio signal out. Now the next thing to do is to tell our video conferencing platform that it should take the audio not directly from the microphone, but from the out jack, virtual jack, of our VB audio cable. So let's open a Zoom meeting. After we've opened our Zoom meeting, but it can be Teams, Skype, or any other video conferencing platform, we have to tell Zoom that it should take the audio not from the microphone, but from the out of the virtual audio cable. Let's go to the microphone options. This is my standard Yeti microphone. Now I have to select cable output VB audio virtual cable. Let's unmute. And as I speak, you see the green bar going up and down, meaning that the audio is going from OBS to Zoom. Depending on the processing power of the computer, but also on how many filters you are using in OBS, you may experience a sync offset between audio and video. There are two ways you can find out whether you have sync offset. The first one is to ask your colleagues whether they see a lag between your audio and video. But testing this live during a video call may not be ideal. So what you can do is just record a Zoom meeting where you are alone. There's a very simple method to identify whether you have a sync offset. That is the clapping method. Just record a Zoom session and do 2 to 3 claps. Just rewatch the video and move forward frame by frame. By doing so, you'll be able to realize whether the sound is coming before or after you see your hands clapping. Now let's assume you've spotted that there is a sync offset and go back to OBS to fix it. Filters. And here in the Audio Monitor plugin, you'll see a delay. This will work in case your audio comes before the video. Then you can introduce a delay in your audio. If the sync offset is minimal, you can start with 50 milliseconds and then try to clap again on Zoom. If that's not enough, you can try to increase it to, for example, 100 milliseconds, or 200, or whatever works for you until you found the right setting. And that will fix it in case your audio comes before the video. If instead it's your video that comes before the audio, then we have to introduce a delay in the video. We do that by adding our video capture device source, as I did right now, right-clicking, filters, going to the Effect Filters tab, click on plus, and look for Render Delay. Click on it. And in here, we can introduce a value between 0 and 500 milliseconds. And now you see that my audio is coming before my video because I've introduced a 500 milliseconds delay in the video. In the exceptional case where you need to introduce even a larger delay for your video, then you simply go to plus and add another Render Delay effect. Let's say we add another 500 milliseconds, and this delay will sum up to the one of the first render delay filter. If I now clap, you see that the video is coming 1 second after the clapping sound. If you like this video, I have a little suggestion for you here. What you can do for you now is to watch this next video where you will learn how to improve the audio, for example, by reducing the noise or compressing it. In other words, giving it a more podcasty sound. See you in my next digital tip.